50 साइडचे रेसिड्यू सापडलेले आहेत आणि संपूर्ण कॉटन तो परत भारतामध्ये आला आणि शेतकऱ्यांचे हाल झाले. गव्हर्नमेंटला शेवटी कॉम्पेन्सेशन करून ते पैसे भरून द्यावे लागले. तर म्हणून तेव्हापासून हे सॅनिटेशनचं सुरू झालं की ते रेसिड्युअल इफेक्ट त्याच्यामध्ये जे काही इन्सेक्टिसाइड पेस्टिसाइड आपण हे करतो किंवा पाणी जे आहे पाण्यामधून सुद्धा वेगवेगळे जे दूषित पाण्याचे जे आहे ते जर प्लांट्सला दिलं गेल्यामुळे त्याचे सुद्धा रेसिड्युअल इफेक्ट ते सुद्धा आपल्या लॅबोरेटरीमध्ये सर टेस्ट होऊ शकतात. इतकी आपली अडव्हान्स अशी लॅबोरेटरी केलेली आहे. आणि आप्पा सरांनी सांगितलं होतं की ही आपल्याला कोकण करता करायची आहे, परंतु आता सूचना आता आली की आता ही महाराष्ट्र राज्या करता करायची आहे. महाराष्ट्र राज्याची झाली तर आपल्याला पुन्हा देशामध्ये सुद्धा ही लॅबोरेटरी आपल्याला हे करायची आहे, कारण पूर्ण झालेला आहे. आणि याच्याकरता आमची संपूर्ण यंत्रणा ही तुमच्या पाठीशी आहे आणि आम्ही आताच ह्या शुभ मुहूर्तावरती 100 सॅम्पल आणि हा आम्ही जो सॅम्पल एनपीके म्हणजे नायट्रोजन कुठलं पीक घ्यायचं हे संपूर्ण त्याच्यावरती अवलंबून असतं एनपीके वर. बाकीचे जे मायक्रो न्यूट्रियंट्स आहेत त्या मायक्रो न्यूट्रियंट्सचे जे आहे तर तो सर्वसामान्य शेतकऱ्याला परवडणार नाही असं, परंतु याची फी जी आहे एनपीकेची ती फक्त 15 रुपयाची ही सबसिडाईज आहे. ऍक्च्युली ते अनालिसिस करायला मिनिमम 75 रुपये लागतात. वर्मा मॅडमला मी सांगितलं की ते एक सॅम्पल अनालिसिस करायला 75-75 रुपये लागतात, पण गव्हर्नमेंटने ते 15 रुपये ही ठेवलेली आहे आणि सर्व महाराष्ट्रामध्ये 15 रुपयाप्रमाणेच हे करतात. आज आम्ही ह्या याच्या मुहूर्तावरती 100 सॅम्पल आणि 1500 रुपये रोख रक्कम आहे. परंतु शासनाचे जे शासन म्हणजे सर आपणच आहात, आपणच निर्धारित करून दिलेली ही आहे, तुमच्या सूचनाचं पालन करायचं आहे, त्यामुळे लॉस आणि हे शेवटी तुम्ही जर देह बघायचं आहे. आम्ही फक्त सूचनांचं पालन करणारे आहोत आणि त्यानुसार सर आम्ही ह्या म्हणजे मुहूर्तावरती मी आणलेला आहे. तर आप्पा सरांना विनंती करतो की त्यांच्या म्हणजे ह्या लॅबोरेटरी सुरू होते तर तुमच्या हस्ते कारण नियम तुम्ही बनवणार त्याचं फक्त आम्ही फॉलो राहू, आम्ही त्या नियमाचं पालन करणार आहोत. त्यामुळे ते ज्या पद्धतीने तुमच्या सूचना आहेत शासनाच्या तुम्ही सूचना दिलेल्या त्या पद्धतीने सर आम्ही कारवाई केलेली आहे. तर मग मी दीपा मॅडमला विनंती करतो तुमच्या हस्ते सर संपूर्ण शेतकऱ्याचं नाव त्याचा सर्वे नंबर कुठलं क्षेत्र आहे ते संपूर्ण आणि तो सॅम्पल काय आता फार मोठे होतो ते काय तर अशी अत्यंत आपली अत्याधुनिक लॅबोरेटरी आपल्याला आप्पा सरांच्या मार्गदर्शनाने मिळालेली आहे आणि तुम्ही फार भाग्यवान आहात. त्याचा अत्यंत सखोल अभ्यास करून तुम्ही त्यांच्या तुमच्या बुद्धीला चालना द्या आणि सरांनी जे मोठं हे म्हणजे हे विजन जे ठेवलेलं आहे त्यांचे मी ह्या कृषी खात्याच्या वतीने आभार मानून माझे 2 शब्द
थँक्यू जाधव सर. ड्युरिंग बायोवॅक्शियस दॅट इंटर कॉलेज फेस्ट वी हॅड टू गिव्ह वन स्पेशल प्राईज. So we had invited that student, Mr. Arun Pawar. I request our Sanjeev Patil sir to please felicitate him. Arun Pawar from Pasteur College. Arun Pawar is a candidate who has been representative of Jaimin College, now he is in Patkar College, and past 3 years he is winning a prize at Vivacious every year. So this is a special prize being given to him. We wanted that this prize he should take today because this is a precious day for us. Thank you, Arun.
Do you want to say something? No, sir.
He's overwhelmed now. Okay, taking the program ahead, I request my colleague Mori Madam, Sneha Mori Madam, to introduce our chief guest.
Good evening all. It's a great privilege to our chief guest, Madam, is Associate Professor in Botany at Ruya College, Convener of Research, and in charge of Herbal Research Laboratory and Animal Testing Center. Her area of specialization is development of QC methods and preclinical studies of herbal and ASU formulation. This dynamic personality is Dr. Mrs. Sunita Shailajan. Madam has published 63 research papers at national and international conferences and 2 patents to her credit, which has added colorful feathers to her cap. Also, a recognized guide in botany and bioanalytical science. She has been awarded with Top Reviewer Award in 2011 from Journal of Ethnopharmacology. She was and is a principal investigator in government-funded projects such as AYUSH, UGC, DBT, BARC, to mention a few. She has established a strong industry-academia linkage with many industries all over India. I request our President, Shri Hitendraji Thakur, to present a ma'am a memento as a token of our gratitude and respect. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mohan, madam. Now, here comes the time where madam will guide us on exactly what is the basic core of research and how this lab we can take the new height so that our president who wants to see it on the map really visualizes it one day. So, I request Sunita ma'am to please go ahead.
Good evening, one and all. It's always a moment of awkwardness when somebody is reading your CV, because then everybody is clapping and expecting a lot from the person. Let me tell you frankly, whatever he read out is all quite simple. And if you start at this age where you have got an excellent lab, which I declare open formally from today, you can achieve wonders. Probably if you invite me to your colleges later on, say probably 10 years down the line, I'm trying to show I'm quite much younger. So 10 years down the line, I'll come and I'll tell you that, see, you have also achieved it. Now, jokes apart, I mean it. Everybody has been mentioning from your trustees, from your principal and others also, your teachers also, that you have got a good lab. But it's normally we have this habit that when someone from home tells you something, you don't believe it. When someone from outside says something, so much has been happening in herbal medicines, but we don't care about it because it's only in India. One article published from USA, Europe, some other country, and everybody starts talking about it. So the same way everybody has been telling you from home that it's a good lab, I actually sincerely tell you that it is an excellent lab. You have got good facilities at your doorstep, in your house. I really mean it. I'm absolutely looking very serious about it. Because I started my career in Ruya College. So now when I say Ruya College, let me just say that I'm highly envious of your campus, your big number of students, because on the whole total we are only 5,000 in Ruya College Arts and Science College, because we cannot expand so much there. Definitely, everybody is, and I'm also proud of my college, but I'm seeing a competition, sir. I'm not too happy about it. It means I have to go back to Ruya and work a lot. I have to also arrange some programs and call probably the eminent personalities from your trustees. I have already invited them and told them that, see, you need some change. Everyone needs some change in life. So when you want to do something for students, for the society, for colleges, you please now include Ruya College also in your list. Okay? So I'm sure I'm going to invite them shortly. Now, coming back to your lab, because I know I can actually say, I take pride in saying that I'm basically a botanist. But this is the era of interdisciplinary, multidisciplinary research. And you all can see in your logo also, I'm so happy about it. I'm so happy that I learned so many things about agriculture. Students, dear students, youngsters, and I can see so many youngsters as colleagues. I'm actually feeling quite old over here. But nonetheless, I would take pride in that I have learned something with the SAGE also. So you can see that there is botany, there is molecular biology, there is water, there is agriculture. Agriculture is a field where you can do so much work. And you with little efforts of yours, because there is less of sophisticated work done in agriculture, so there is a lot of scope for you. You can easily achieve a lot of things. With all the due respect to biotechnology, it's not just that biotechnology can do wonders. This is what is speaking is the botanist in me, that with agriculture you can do lots, because government gives you subsidy, as you just heard also, for sample analysis it's only 15 rupees, but you look at the farmers, that farmers can get the analysis done at the rupees 15. Okay, so in short, I will tell you that, as I already told you, I'm seeing a big competition for Ruya College. So tomorrow when I go back, I have to inform my principal that this is what I have seen. So please wake up. As you all have been saying that I'm not in South Bombay. Ruya College is generally we have middle class crowd in Ruya College. Ruya College is not catering only to students from very sophisticated modern families, but we have, you know, Dadar is an area where the crowd is quite middle class. So our values are also middle class values. Now middle class word is not middle class. That word is, the middle class carries the values in our society ahead. I'm quite proud of it, that I belong to that middle class. So it's not that people always feel that there is lots in South Bombay. That way when I stay in Thane. So when we are in somewhere in Bandra and you just you want to give your address to somebody, maybe to the shopkeeper, and then he says, where do you stay, and you say Thane, he looks at you, oh, where is Thane? I don't care about it, because I am happy in Thane. I get in Thane, though I am not a Maharashtrian, but born brought up in Bombay, and I get that culture in Thane what I wouldn't get in Bandra. Right? So the same way you get so many things in Virar which you wouldn't get in Dadar or you wouldn't get in Thane. Nonetheless, you should be also going out. And that is what we have been doing in the courses like bioanalytical sciences. Now I would like to say something about this. Your principal sir mentioned that your college has been starting courses where lots of investment has to be done. That's true. Your college started a course like bioanalytical sciences. Your college started a course in PG like herbal sciences, and you must pardon me that when Deepa and Rohan, they told me, I'm quite closely associated, by the way, with your college through Deepa and Rohan. I came only once as examiner, but I'm always, whenever I think, I hope, whenever they need anything, they just give me a call, and either the students come to our college or we just advise them what is to be done. So these courses, when they told me that they want to start bioanalytical sciences, so actually I did not believe it, and I little discouraged them also, because I told them that many colleges start this course and they cannot run it, because then there are well established colleges, I don't want to name them, that for years they have been sending their students out for AAS, for GCMS and etc. Even if they have the instruments are obsolete, old instruments. Or even if it is there, there is some problem of sometimes load shedding, sometimes maintenance, etc. And I'm so happy that you have taken care of everything here. And this is, I'm not in that, neither in that age nor that experience that I can advise you all. But as a teacher, definitely, I'm so happy for my students and for my colleagues that here in Virar, in this college, you can do wonders in research, you can do so many projects. little she spoke about my projects which I have from Government of India. And I would like to tell you that when you apply for these projects, it's not money which matters. Even if you get about 15 lakhs for 3 years, it's the title which you get. It's the recognition which you get. It's the experience which you get. And that starts something within you, and then there is no looking back. So, dear students, you have to believe me that you really have a good lab. And you know, teachers cannot be bribed in any way. The teacher comes out anywhere. So I mean it that you have a good lab, sophisticated lab. I'm so happy that you are allowed to use those instruments. And Deepa rightly so, she said that in many colleges, they will only see the instruments. Maybe you can just touch them. Maybe you can just use little switch on, switch off under some technical assistance. And here I saw students standing with those instruments in the lab when I inaugurated the lab down, and they're working on it. So it's just a matter of time. It takes little time in the lab in research that they have invested such a big amount. I definitely have to take some tips from them. How did he, Mr. Shashank, bargain for instruments, and how do you do the insurance of the instruments?